Hey, was that delicious?
I don't drink, like, ever.
Oh, my God.
It's really good tequila.
Oh, my God. Yeah, that was great.
You ready, little man?
No.
What do you mean? You ready, Dave? Do it. You want to throw first? Me throw.
Man, he's competitive.
Hey, go home, Dave. Get out of here. Yeah. You're gonna be the best cornhole player in the world one day? No.
I got carried.
I came in at the end, but couldn't close it out.
Dude, my back hurts.
Okay, bro.
So I low-key almost got beat by a kid, but he was good. So the dad, Dave, likes to play cornhole. So we actually banned him from the competition, but he's like, I'll play. Let me play, but let me play left-handed. So the only reason we won is because he played left-handed. We got lucky. All right, that was a good cornhole tournament. I actually, even after all those beers, had a few. I think I had six or seven beers from 10 a.m. to 1. So I definitely did feel it. Now, I still came in and I still worked out. Check it out. I did a back squat for my first time in months, and I was a little scared going down, so I was moving slow, but I was actually surprised at how heavy that felt. That was not cool. That was only 325 that I hit for three. Granted, it was after a mile running 50 box jumps. Shout out to Steph. She almost beat me in that workout. She's a fast runner, but I feel like I should be more fit. But shouts out to you, Steph, for being such an amazing athlete and really keeping up with me on that one, because that was a doozy. So right now it is celebration for Hector's birthday, and we are getting ready to go out to eat. It's about 4 o'clock right now. I need to go home, take a shower, get ready, and we'll see how he is. He seemed a little grumpy at me earlier, so I know you're gonna edit this too, but seemed a little grumpy at me earlier. I can't quite pinpoint what it is, but we're gonna go and we're gonna try to have a good night out. And the fights are tonight as well, so I'll see you guys on the other side.
Got a sake bomb, first one.
You want to taste the sake?
You know what you need to do, right?
Just jump it in, right?
Let me see.
Are we ready?
Pour it in and chug it.
Oh, this is for Hector and Kelsey's birthday. Happy birthday, guys.
See you guys.
Cheers.
Love you guys.
Happy birthday.
All right, so right now, we're sitting in the gym. I'm getting ready to train, but I wanted to go over really quick what shoes you guys should be wearing when you're doing CrossFit. So I just kind of lined up a few pairs of shoes here that we can look at. So we got some Brooks, we got running shoes, we got our Nike Metcon Free 3s, we've got a pair of Metcon 4-5s, pair of Metcon 5s, and we got some Reebok. I think these are Nano 8s. So overall, I think we just want to match what kind of activity we're doing to the type of training. So, or match our shoes to the type of training that we're doing. So, if you're going to be wearing some Brooks, make sure that you're running. And these are going to be super cushiony. They're not going to be great for training. You advanced athletes, if you need to do it, like you guys did the Nasty Nancy where you needed to do overhead squats, but then you also needed to do running, prioritize your running. So feel free to do some overhead squats or some Olympic lifting in your running shoes, but overall it's like not gonna be the shoe that you wanna use. If I was gonna do something like that, I would choose more of a hybrid shoe. So this still gives you the luxury of being able to run, but it also still gives you the stability in the heel to where you can do all your regular lifting. So I actually really like these shoes. I will say they are a little bit tight on my feet, but I haven't really worn them enough to say, hey, these end up being really good training shoes. On the other end of the spectrum, my favorite pair of shoes are gonna be the Metcon 5, 6, I don't really care, just a pair of Metcons in general. So, cool thing about these, the ridges here, these catch the rope whenever you guys do rope climbs. This back piece, this plastic, allows you to do good handstand push-ups because it lowers the amount of friction that's on the wall. It's like a small contact point, right? You can see the little ridge here. It's a small contact point. The small contact point, like I said, that just supplies less friction on the wall, makes it a little bit smoother and more efficient. I've never really trained in Reeboks, but a lot of people love them, but they're gonna be your equivalent. They're gonna be your Nike equivalent. So nice stable base, still good for you to be doing your squats, your deadlifts and everything inside the gym. But ultimately, I promise you, you're not gonna enjoy running in a pair of Metcons and or a pair of Nanos. So just when you guys are picking your shoes, go anywhere on the board, but make sure it goes towards the type of activity you're doing. If you're running, wear running shoes. If you're not running, wear training shoes. If you want bang for your buck, pick a Metcon Free 3, that way you can do both. So, I don't know, just wanted to go over some different shoes for you guys to be able to pick whenever you guys are out doing some CrossFit.
Finally, it's happening. I've probably emailed, I don't know, 15 screen printers in the last, well, it took me a little longer than I wanted, but I emailed a shit ton of screen printers and then none of them wanted to print on our shirts. One, people didn't want to print on them because it wasn't their product that they were having, which means they really just wanted to make more product off of the shirt itself. And then the other reason people didn't want to print on these was because, well, they'll print on the sweatshirts, that's not a problem, they'll do the embroidery piece. But the other part was the fact that they didn't want to print on the polyester, because essentially what happens whenever you start printing on polyester, the print is fine, it's the heating process to cure it. Whenever the jacket gets over 300 degrees, I think it's called migration. Basically what happens is a gas releases from the polyester into the ink and it'll change the color of the ink. So I had to get some instructions from the manufacturer, send them to a screen printer and be like, hey, will you please print on these? And finally, I literally found these people and they were just like, yeah, no problem. We do that all the time. So we're just leaving the print shop right now. So I didn't bring a camera in there just in case they weren't too camera friendly. So I dropped off. Initially, I went in there to bring both the women's hoodie and the windbreakers in so they could get printed on. But basically what happened is, what happens at a lot of stores, I might have said it in the last clip, is people don't want to print on things that are not their product. Now these guys were willing to print on it, but they wanted to charge $10 a unit for a small bee, no more than like a 2x2. And it's like, you're gonna charge me $10 a unit just to put a bee on here? I get it, digitizing, I get it, it's extra labor, but it's like, you literally just told me you're charging me extra. So I was like, let me go find someone else that can do it for even if I can get it at $7 or $5 a unit for the embroidery, I'd rather do that. But after all the time, finally finding someone that will print on these windbreakers is absolutely amazing. And I hope the best, like, I want to give them business. I want to give local businesses business. But at the end of the day, I'm also looking here to make profit. So if businesses don't look out for me, I'm not going to look out for them. So on the way back to the gym, go back into some training sessions, and then hopefully get a workout in here. Just a few. Cacti's not no iced tea. Got them bamboozled like I'm Spike Lee. You need more than Google just to find me. I just call a beta, get a hyphy. Ooh. Incredible, general. I just start the label just to sign me. Me and Chase connected like we Siamese. We been on a run, feel like a crime spree. Talk to me nicely. Yeah. I seen his face, seen it. Yep, on his white tee. Yeah. All right, so back at the house. Shirts are done. They're sent off. The windbreakers are done. We've got so many things coming up that I'm super excited to really show you the true finished product with this clothing. From the windbreakers, they're going to be fully tagged, they're going to have hang tags, they're going to be in their poly sleeves, and they're going to go in the poly mailers. We've got a
a thermal printer coming so we can send out all of our mail pieces. Like, this is truly going to be the first time where I have a completely finished product for the clothing, and I'm super excited to share it with you, which we will have those posted up on social media here shortly, and we'll definitely show it here in the vlog, like a more detailed, more about the fit and what we have to offer with our new clothing. But right now, not necessarily more importantly, but what we're doing is, I may have said it, but we are doing a carb cycling challenge. Essentially, what we're going to do is we're going to take our total calories. If you want to lose weight, that's fine. But I'm going in the maintenance route. If I end up getting too hungry, or if I end up actually losing weight, my goal is to go from maintenance, which if I'm losing weight, I'm not really in my maintenance. To go from my maintenance and then go into a surplus so I can actually gain weight doing carb cycling. All carb cycling is, my goal is to end up getting leaner, but it's just to take your carbs and manipulate them throughout time and lower them throughout the 6-week period in an attempt to get our, in an attempt for me to end up getting leaner. 15% body fat right now, 15.1. I weighed in at 179. The goal is to get down to 12%, which I haven't been 12% or 11% in like 5 years. So this will be interesting. So right here, we've got rice cake, peanut butter, and Greek yogurt. This is my end of the night meal. So we're day 4 into the carb cycling challenge. I'm on a low carb day. So I ate a majority of my carbs post-workout so I can get that to refeed myself. And then here at the end of the night, I've only got like 20, 25 carbs left. So I'm eating a little bit of rice cake as well as some peanut butter with some Greek yogurt for the protein. Follow me along on this carb cycling challenge, guys. It'll be interesting. I'm ready to show you my transformation and how hard I'm willing to work to get to where we want to be. So that is the end of this video, guys. Stay posted. We're going to post even more about the carb cycling challenge. Make sure you guys give this thing a thumbs up. Make sure you guys subscribe to the channel. Make sure you guys follow me on Instagram @Barboza. And I will see you guys next time. Peace.